And good morning. No, I didn't get a haircut. I just decided to put my hair in a ponytail this morning. For those of you that may wonder, different look, I know. Anyway, our extended weekend here in the United States is now over, with President's Day celebrated yesterday. Actually, it's my grandson's, what will he be? Four. Yeah, I think he's going to be 4 years old on Wednesday. Quite a little character, Mr. Armand. Anyway, today's title is 2012 Different Roles with One Goal. As I keep saying, and as Spirit keeps reminding me, each individual and each grouping of individuals is playing a specific role. Not all roles have the same function, and often they may appear to be doing opposite things. However, there is an overriding principle at work that will ultimately prove very powerful. That the entire cosmos manifests love. It is only from the heart of love that we can change ourselves and thereby the world. Some think unity is a New Age concept. Actually, it is the goal of divine love, a cohesive power that opens the eyes to reveal how things really work. In other words, to actually see the bigger picture. As I looked back on my life reflecting this morning, following an email that I received from Derek Maddox, which I'll share in a minute, I realized the wide range of ideas and perceptions that I've been asked and almost forced in some cases to observe through the course of my life. I've had to let my concepts of God and my concepts of what I thought was true almost totally collapse sometimes to be able to see a new paradigm, a new structure, a new way of organizing the perceptions into a pattern that makes sense to the mind and to the, and more importantly, to the spirit of my own heart, which is love. And I didn't always realize that, and sometimes I have moments when I still seem to forget it when I jump into judgment of those that I don't understand. Anyway, Derek wrote, "Ron, I finally had a chance to listen to your video today, as I usually do, and I was pleasantly surprised to hear you quoting a post that I did on Facebook. I am humbled and appreciative for you doing this. I made this post because I'm seriously concerned that religious differences are going to destroy the Republic. I have an unusual background. In my childhood, I was exposed to a wide variety of Christian religions. In my teens, I became an atheist. I became a Jehovah's Witnesses in my 20s, and then I left the Witnesses in my late 40s. I describe myself as a pantheist who believes in Spinoza's God. This varied background gives me a unique perspective because I have defended both sides of the religion-non-religion debate throughout my life. Both sides are absolutely certain that they're right, and they refuse to listen to anything that the other guys say. We've got to figure out a way to break up these factions. I'll be honest, I don't have a clue how to do this, but we've got to solve this problem before it festers too much. What do you think, Derek?" Well, Derek and everyone else, what I think and what I keep being reminded is that there is a higher plan at work. Regardless of all the splinter groups that we see everywhere, regardless of all the egos shouting, "I'm right and you're wrong," regardless of all this nonsense, which is part of the process apparently, there is a grand scheme of things that is being worked out. And because we have amnesia, And we come in forgetting who we are and forgetting how interconnected we are and forgetting how we knew different souls on the other side of this earthly equation. Forgetting all of those things, we come in here with our eyes closed, blinded to all other possibilities than the one that we're focused on right now. And every one of us, when we're going through a particular experience and focusing on a particular set of ideas, a particular paradigm of reality, every one of us thinks that this is right. Because that's how we learn. We have to first assimilate it into ourselves so that we feel it, so that we can know it. And thereby we have to be with a unitary purpose and a unitary focus. This is the truth. And it is. It's just that it's not the whole truth. Because apparently this process is one of developing many perspectives and then putting the pieces together, allowing all of these fragments to have their individual experiences and then collectively amassing them into a beautiful tapestry where all of a sudden the eyes are open and say, oh, I was one of the terrorists. Oh, I was one of the elite. Oh, I was one of the witches that was burned at the stake. Oh, I was a Christian defending the faith. Oh, I was a Muslim. Oh, I was a Hindu. Oh, I was white. Oh, I was black. Oh, I was a Native American. Oh, I was Oriental. Oh, I was this. I was that. Oh, and we start to see, even if we don't think it was me that was that, we have all of these little pieces of me or of the divine playing these different roles in our lives. So we get to watch the bigger picture. And here in 2012, and in the last several years leading up to this, since we've had the internet, the world has gotten smaller, hasn't it? Because we now are able to look, if we're willing to open our eyes and look, we're able to look at people from all over the world and hear expressions. I watched a video yesterday of a man ranting that's hurting. And I mean, just as I feel God knows my pain, I felt his pain. I felt it. And I watch other videos where people are bubbling with joy, and it's my joy. It's my pain. It's my joy. They're all parts of me. They're all parts of my experience. And as I recognize that they're all parts of me, that they're all expressions of things that I have felt, things that I have gone through, circumstances that are being expressed, are circumstances that by one in one way or another have been my circumstances. And this creates a bigger and bigger heart or an expanded capability to love everyone. And that's where we're going. I think that I'm an archetype along with many others. I don't think I'm the archetype, but I'm an archetype of the healing process that is going on in humanity. As we finally break down the walls, or begin at least to break down the walls, and recognize the wisdom of God in not putting all of the truth in one basket, in creating religions on different parts of the globe that people could grow into and experience. But now, with the mass movement of people around the globe, where you've got Asians living in Europe and Europeans living in Asia and Africans living everywhere and Americans scattered and Native Americans visiting other places that they never would have visited before, you've got all of this movement going on in the world, and it's creating an opening for an awareness. An awareness that no matter what part of the world we come from, no matter what religion we may believe is the religion, no matter what philosophy we may be adopting, we're all basically united in one thing. We all have at least some ability to feel. And in our emotions, in the expression of human emotion, you can look at pictures and you can see that person is terrified. You can see that person is awed. You can see that person is so in love. You can see it just by looking at their face, looking at the countenance. It doesn't even need words. It doesn't even need definition, because intuitively we can recognize it. Those of us that have opened up the most can recognize it the most. We have the most empathy. We have the most ability to recognize ourself and our own reflection in another. And this is the dynamic that is sweeping the planet. This is the thing that's changing the world. Derek's experience of being on both seemingly opposite paradigms in one lifetime, this is going to happen with many, many, many people. And sometimes it's not even just two paradigms. It might be more than two. You might get so many perspectives, your head will spin if you try to put them all together rationally. And yet, it's not a rational process of integrating these things. It's a process of the heart. It's a spiritual process. It's a divine process. And sometimes, as Derek says, I don't know how to solve this problem. I don't know how to do this. And boy, have I been there, haven't you? That it the confusion seems so enormous that how to develop a cohesive focus, which I'm calling love, is almost beyond our grasp, beyond our ability to even comprehend. And yet somehow it's being worked out, and it's escalating. It's escalating in 2012. It escalated in 2011. It's escalating even more in 2012. But it's no time. It's not a date that we're looking for. It's a movement. It's energy in motion. It's emotion that is showing us the way. And some people are afraid of emotion. Get over it. Because emotion is merely the witnessing of movement. And we can witness it externally or internally. When we begin to do it internally and we stop the war within ourselves and we start saying, hey, wait a minute, I'm feeling angry. What's this about? We don't push it away. We don't deny it. We look at it. What's this about? And then our eyes somehow open. And if we really look and if we're really silent, we can see the gift that's in the so-called negative emotion. And we can express it in a whole way, in a loving way, in a healing way, which is what whole means, by the way. Whole is just bringing things back to a state of homeostasis, a state where apparent opposites dance instead of dueling. This is the alchemy, the divine alchemical process that is going on in the human family. And it's a cosmic thing because we're not just here on Earth. A part of us is beyond the Earth. A part of us has always been celestial. We are not only terrestrial beings, we are celestial beings as well. And we have a family that's bigger than the family that we're aware of even on Earth. And we're becoming aware of this if we're patient. Now, we can go through the periods of depression, go through the periods of ranting and anger, and it's okay. It's a process. People that are in the know aren't going to judge you for it. In fact, they're going to applaud you for engaging the process. In fact, the higher part of ourselves, the celestial part, and the family that's still in the celestial realms, we call them ETs or angels, they have applauded those of us with the courage to take on this amnesia and come down into the world, forgetting everything and having to rediscover it all over again until it becomes part of us, until our divine selves know it all. But not just because it knows, but because it knows by experience. This is the land of experience. This is the ground of actual unfolding, step by step, who we are. It's all about self-discovery. And who are we? Who am I? Who are you? We are love. We are each aspects of one divine creator that shall forever remain hidden from our view. No one can actually see that at any time because it's bigger than any of us could possibly perceive. Yet we can perceive this piece, this piece, this piece, this piece, this piece, and say they're all pieces of the one. The creator has always been hidden within the creation. The one who has worked all things always after the counsel of his own will, her own will, because it's not gender specific. It's both genders and all possibilities. This is what the creator is, and the creation manifests the all possibilities. So yes, we have different roles, but the role of love is to open our eyes so that we can embrace the different roles, the different aspects, the different parts of our own being, and in embracing them, we are transformed. And that transformation is the awakening. That transformation is the love that bears no record of evil, the love that is perfect, the love that forgives, the love that integrates the opposites into a place of wisdom instead of a place of antagonism. I ask you to consider these thoughts today as you look at people that you want to judge, as you look at groups that you want to hate. Yes, we can all find them, me too. But are they not playing a role in the divine scheme of things, which ultimately has a one goal, a one purpose? And that purpose is summed up in the prayer of Jesus in the garden, Father, that they all may be one in us, that the world, the physical manifestation, might know the spiritual reality of unity. I leave you with these thoughts. Namaste.